Hey, good evening folks, or good morning, probably morning when you're watching this. That's what Heather and I got done so far today. It may not look like much, but we anchored all of these down here on the outside. We put this board on the outside as well. This guy here, we snapped a chalk line, straightened everything up. Started putting floorboards down, as you can see. And we anchored down the centers here as well. We bolted those down. And that's a little bit of a floor we did there. What do you think, Heather? Feels good?
Feels very good.
Pretty strong, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't wiggle at all.
No, it doesn't.
So that's what we got.
It's really nice.
Yeah. There will be a wall on top of this. Be a wall running right down here. I straightened out. This is pretty straight too as well. As you can see. Maybe a little bit of a curve there, but nothing serious. I think it might be an illusion. It looks pretty straight from here. Anyways, that's how the boards look. We just started this just this evening. Heather's brother showed up, so we stopped to visit for a little bit, but that's what we got done. So we're well on our way. Now I have to straighten that wall out. Once we get to that, when we go to put our 6x6 on top of there, see, I have to bring it up. There'll be a 6x6 and then a 1 inch on top of that because it all has to come up. See, the floor joist is 6 inch and this is 1 inch. So that has to be brought up same as we're running a 4 foot high wall all the way around here, all the way around and back to here once this floor is on here. That's what we got done today, folks. Oh, we trimmed up the far side as well. All the far side is trimmed up too. We did all that. We didn't even have time to turn on the camera. I know I should have, but I didn't, and I'm sorry, but that's how things go sometimes when you're in a hurry to get things done. So, let me step back over here. Hopefully I don't slip on the sawdust. That as well. Snapped the chalk line down there and trimmed them all off as well. And that's, like I said, a little bit of a... So you see how I did the floor? I did that diagonal like I said I was going to. But these are pretty strong, man. Holy mackerel. That floor don't bounce when you jump on it, I'll tell you. It doesn't go nowhere. Hey, it's looking good.
And you're hammering them in, not air
nailing. Oh, yes, I'm not using the air nailer. So I'm using those 3-inch zinc dipped Ardoch nails, not galvanized, they're zinc dipped from what I understand. Out here to put this outside board on, we hammered those in. Heather and I took turns. We used 5-inch Ardoch spikes. That's an 8-inch board, so it goes into this, it's flush with the top of this 6-inch, and it goes down 2-inch into that bottom 6-inch beam right there. 5x6. So it's nailed into the floor joist plus into that 5-inch underneath there. So there should be none of this either because that 2x8's all nailed in there. And we used 5-inch Ardochs on that. So this outside board is a real 2-inch thick by real full-size 8-inch deep. And yeah, we used 5-inch Ardoch spikes, 4 of them in each floor joist. So 2 in the floor joist, 2 in the bottom of that beam, so that's good. Yeah, comfortable?
It is.
Good view?
It
well,
is.
Maybe not over there, not with my junk pile, but I like that view.
I like it, yeah, it's not bad.
You can sure see a long ways, can't you, up here?
Yeah.
Once those trees are gone out of there, that little bit of trees, and these little bit of trees here are gone, on this side of the ravine, you'll be able to see right down there because that is all going to get sloped nicely down over there. So from here, you'll be able to see right down over. That's how that'll go. It'll look nice, I think. But, yep, that's what we did. Just a quick little video here, folks, I wanted to show you. Like I say, we didn't turn on the camera, and I'm sorry. But we got at this early this morning. We even did a little bit of milling, too. We covered the mill up as well, but we went through some of those. Now there's some 2-inch down there that we're gonna rip into 2x8s because we need it for a board like this to go on the other side. And right there, that last, those last two over there, I have to take them, I have to unbolt them, I have to push them both out a little bit because it kind of wows, I guess. I'll show you when I walk down here. You'll see what I mean. My legs are getting tired after being up and around here all day. But if you see here, you see how that wows inward? It goes like this. So I want to take that and push her out a little bit, out to the edge of that log maybe or so. But remember, it's not supposed to look perfectly square. It's going to look rustic. That's why we went with the rough floorboards. And well, it'd be nice to have this all, the floor all sheeted in, and we can start on the floor. Jump up and down on that. How much did it move? Try it again. That's pretty solid, eh? Yeah. Try it again. Moves a little bit, but that's to be expected, though. Yeah.
Pretty good.
Pretty solid, eh?
This thing's pretty good.
Once we get all of them, all those boards nailed this way, it's going to get even more solid because it's going to tie them all together.
Yeah.
That's pretty good. Well, let's go take a look at the view from down below, looking up. What do you think?
Sounds good.
We'll see you down there. All right, let's take a look what it looks like from under here. I'm just gonna leave that saw right there. Shouldn't get dripped on too much under there. I mean, there is a bit of a space, but they're not fitting totally tight because it is rough lumber, but that's how it's looking. Once we're done, we'll be up there and we'll, I've been slowly pulling that bark off, but some of them I didn't get, but I won't tell anybody if you don't. That's how it's looking so far. Be nice to have that all closed in. There's not much room, there's not much space, I'll tell you, in between those floor joists. And it's nice having that outside board on there as well. That really made it look straight and clean once we got that on. I think it's gonna look good, folks. You leave me a little comment if you don't mind and let me know what you think. I think it's coming along really good. Those anchors too, I have those anchors in there as well. So that's not gonna go anywhere under there. Got those red brackets. We have another red bracket over here as well. I think you've seen that before. So that's not going nowhere either. Up there, hey, it's hard to see, isn't it? A little dark, maybe it shows up better off camera. And that's still sitting pretty level. Hasn't moved at all. So we got that far, and like I said, you see I did that diagonally like I was talking about. That's how I did the old house, did it all diagonal. But check that out, hey, I like it. Still enough room to insulate up in the corners up in there, lots of room up there. There'll be house wrap on the outside of this as well, folks, so it'll be house wrap. And we're probably going to go metal siding. I'm not sure. We might go wood siding. I don't know. We'll see what we do, folks. You let us know. Do you think we should do wood siding like the house? Or should we go metal siding?
I think metal.
You think metal because it's faster?
No. Well, partially. But also the reason I think metal is because of the fact that there is more forest fires.
Yeah. And the house sits, I mean, it's a little ways away from trees, but still, I mean, it could take off too, but
yeah.
here maybe, because I don't think I'll be working inside it. We'll see, babe. Once we get this done, we'll see what we think. Okay, we'll see, but how much energy we have.
That's pretty much the only reason I think metal is quicker.
Oh yeah,
I'm not gonna lie. But also it is the forest fire thing.
Yeah.
So we talked about that before.
We did. But I mean, look at my brother's house, is right in amongst the trees too. But it's got aluminum siding. But we have never had a forest fire.
No.
On our place.
But then aren't we due for one?
Well, I mean, we are cleaning off the dead trees too, though. So that helps us a lot because we're keeping the dead trees down. So, I mean, but the temperatures are getting hotter. I'm not sure. I don't know. Maybe I will go a nice steel siding. We'll figure it out.
Don't get me wrong. I think the wood would look really nice.
Like, yeah, like, look at that.
I know. The wood would look beautiful. But, I don't know, it's up to you. You know I'm always game for whatever.
Yeah, I know, I'm undecided too. Maybe we'll let the good folks tell us what they think. Should we go steel siding on the outside? We are going a steel roof, that's for sure, but should we go a steel siding on the outside? Or should we go wood siding like the stuff we made for on the house? I should say for what we're making on the house. We still haven't got that finished yet, but that'll be a winter project. We like doing that kind of stuff in the winter. It's too hot to work in the summer, I find here. Man, it's brutal. Bloody brutal. We got to get back to that too soon, but we really wanted to get the pole barn done to where, you know, we can work on it this winter if we have to, so we're not so the posts are all set straight and everything is square, and now we have the upstairs on it. We'll have the floor sheeted in soon, so then there's just a matter of working up there on that platform there. And we're going to build a platform out 4 feet all the way around here where there is no floor. And that is just, you know, so we can, you know, if we want to store some antiques up there or something, and we can also use that platform to work on the wall. But that's how it's looking. Now, I don't know if it's supposed to rain tomorrow, but I think we're going to start putting some stuff away, I think, soon. But I wanted to give you an overview of how that looks with everything all in place now. So they're all bolted down now, all of this floor joist, and that's how they're looking. I think it's looking pretty great, if I do say so myself. And floorboards are going on nice. They're 3 or 3.5. They might be 3.5 inch Ardoch zinc dipped. But picture that up there, all that bark cleaned off, and it all cleaned off with some nice clear varnish on there. I think that'll look good. Nice clear coat up there. It'll look nice. Anyways, and we'll use that non-yellowing stuff because I don't want it to turn yellow. Heather's up there. She's all set to go in. I have to find something to cover these saws, though. I don't want to leave those saws exposed.
I got that plastic over there.
Isn't it covering our table saw? It's covering our table saw, though, right?
Oh, yeah, I guess I'd have to bring that one over. Oh,
yeah.
You know what? There's more plastic on the over by where the...
We need some tarps, Heather. We've got to invest in some tarps.
Yeah.
That's what we need.
There's more plastic over by the...
By the shed, by the garden shed.
Yeah, but like in behind there.
Yes, I know what you mean. Behind your little car.
Yes.
Behind Tater's Tot.
Yeah. Yeah. Yep.
Alrighty. Anyways, you folks have a great evening. I know this short video and I'm sorry, but if we get back to this tomorrow, if it don't rain, we'll set up the camera and we'll start right away in the morning, because we do have to mill some logs. Mill some logs and cut them and nail them on. We got to make some more 1 inch. These were out of 1 inch. So, yeah. Anyways, you folks take care and we'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye-bye, all.
Bye.